One of the most exciting stages when I first started advocating for animals was when I felt confident to talk about it. But now the question is, how do we initiate these discussions? There's two main ways I like to initiate vegan interactions. I like to first ask people what's going on in their lives, how they're doing, and how are their weeks going. I find if I keep asking them questions, inevitably they'll ask me questions in return, and that's my chance to talk about veganism. The second way I initiate vegan interactions in my own life is by going to vegan outreach events. A great example of this is Anonymous for the Voiceless, which hosts Cube of Truth events. Now, I've done a whole video on how this demonstration is structured, so I encourage you to check that out. In summary, it's an event for everyone, whether you want to interact with others or simply hear others interacting. There's loads of ways we can initiate conversations about veganism. We just have to look for the opportunities. You might have a favorite vegan t-shirt you like to wear. Perhaps a vegan tattoo. What's your favorite way to get conversations about veganism started? Let us know in the comments below. When responding to non-vegans, I like to use a four-step approach. Pause, praise, inform, and ask. Pausing means we wait 3 to 5 seconds after the person has finished speaking to start talking ourselves. This shows people that we're listening to what they have to say, and they're more likely to listen to what we have to say in response. It also gives us a chance to think about what we're going to say next. Praise means finding the positive in what the person said. It may not always seem like it, but there's likely a positive in there somewhere. And if we can water that positive seed, it will naturally blossom into veganism. So how do we apply this to a real interaction? If someone says they're vegetarian, instead of asking them why they aren't vegan, I like to ask them why they went vegetarian. Typically, the reasons they give will segue nicely into the discussion around veganism. If someone says they don't eat that much meat or they're cutting down, I like to ask them the reasons for this too. This again will help segue into veganism. When the person seems ready to take some information on board, that's where we get to the inform step. I like to do this from my experience using I statements, which are less confrontational. For instance, I was shocked to learn how much protein we can get from plants. The inform step goes nicely with my favorite, and that's to ask. Specifically, asking an open-ended question to get the person thinking about veganism. One of my favorites I usually start the interaction off with is, do you think we can be healthy without eating animals? I've found the inform and the ask step go well together. For instance, if you're speaking with a vegetarian, you could say, I was shocked what happens to male offspring for dairy and eggs. What do you think about the dairy and egg industries? I'll be doing a separate video on asking questions, so be sure to check that out. This response praises the positive, builds awareness, and steers the conversation towards a vegan conclusion. One of the most powerful tools in our vegan arsenal is open-ended questions, otherwise known as the Socratic method. Now, the Socratic method is basically the idea of structured questioning to help guide the conversation to a positive result. The first question I like to ask people is if they think we can be healthy without eating animals. If people say yes to this, we've established there's no need to use animals, and I reiterate this throughout the conversation. I then like to talk about the animals, and I'm careful to do so in a way that doesn't imply I'm trying to improve conditions. I do this by focusing on biological facts. For instance, in the dairy and egg industries, half of the offspring have to be male, which means they're not profitable and they're killed straight away. I find that by talking about the animals, it helps people understand that because there's no biological necessity for us to eat them, their use in any way is unethical. The other conversation that frequently comes up is the idea of humane meat. My favorite open-ended question to respond to this is, do you think there's a humane way to kill an animal? If the person says yes, I like to ask that person to describe that process in detail and ask them what they think the word humane means. I go into a whole lot more detail about some of the open-ended questions I like to ask in my free discussion guide that you can find in our download section. The idea is to get people talking about veganism, because if they're talking about veganism, that means they're thinking about veganism, and that means we're doing our jobs. Good communication is just as stimulating as black coffee and just as hard to sleep after. So when we're interacting with others, let's ask them those open-ended questions and give them that cup of coffee. Great, so you've done it. You had that positive vegan interaction. See, it wasn't that hard, was it? But what do you do now? The way I like to close a positive interaction is by pitching the Challenge 22 Plus support program. The way I like to pitch the Challenge 22 Plus program is that it's a free support program where you're put into a Facebook group full of vegan curious people like yourself, and you're given daily challenges and recipe ideas, and you're supported by a team of mentors and registered dietitians. I then like to ask the person, is this something you think you'd be interested in? If the person shows interest, I then ask, would you like to sign up today? I find by breaking this question into two parts and getting that initial buy-in has a much higher chance of success. Even if they don't sign up on the day, perhaps you can give them a card with the necessary information or show them the link to where they can sign up later. If the person doesn't use Facebook, there's several email-based support programs too. I'd recommend Veganuary, which you can use year-round, or the Vegan Society also has a great 30-day email program. Both Challenge 22 Plus, as well as the email-based systems, say that around two-thirds of their participants decide to stay vegan afterwards. This means that by connecting people with that aftercare support, we can turn a positive interaction into lasting change.